Hello and welcome to SAP on Microsoft Azure. My name is Holger Bruchelt, and in this video series, we want to take a closer look behind the scenes of the Extending SAP Solutions Using Microsoft Power Platform webinar. This is chapter 5, where we will continue working on our Power Automate flow to automatically create products in the SAP system, leveraging information from a PDF document from an incoming email. So looking at the overall process flow again, we have started by creating the trigger for Outlook. We have created our forms processing step. So now we have all the information in place to actually create the products in the SAP system. So in this video, we'll focus on the custom connector to create actually the products in SAP. So we have done all the steps here above. The email, the trigger and email is there. From the email list there, we have the process and save information from forms. And now we'll actually jump ahead to the end where we want to add the products to the SAP system. Similar like the update scenario that we had before when we updated the price from the Power App scenario, creating a product requires us to fetch a CSRF token. So that's what this first step, this get product, is all about. And then we'll take a look at the add product functionality, where we need to pass all the required fields, obviously, where we will hard code a few properties, which you probably would not do in a productive environment, but just to show how it can be done. And then we'll use this one to create the product in the SAP system itself. So now that we are able to react to an incoming email, take the attachment and process the PDF document with our product extraction form, let's do the next step and let's try to figure out how we can actually create a product in the SAP system. So the first thing that we'll do is we'll create a new action, and luckily we can still use our custom OData connector that allows us to connect to the SAP system and create a product there. In order to create a product, we actually need to do two steps for this specific SAP system. The first thing is that we need to fetch a so-called XCSRF token. In the next step, we'll then provide this CSRF token to the actual creation process, but first we need to fetch one. In order to get a token, we also need to query for a certain product, and I'll just specify the HT2000, which I know is part of the SAP system, and as a result, we'll get this CSRF token back. Now that we have this token, we can actually start and create the actual SAP product. So for this, we'll take the add product action, which provides us with a list of properties that we need to fill out. So the first one is this XCSRF token, which we can take from the previous step. So from the get product action, we'll just take the XCSRF token step. Now, each of these calls is a completely independent call. And in order to make sure that the CSRF token that we got from the first step is the same or can be reused in the second step, in the second call, we need to make sure that we leverage the very same session. So we need to make sure that the header and cookie information that we got from this first step is also available here for this second step. So what we'll do is we'll take the header information from the first step, so the output from get product headers from this one, we'll take the cookie here and put the cookie here in the second step. While doing this, we'll also replace any commas with semicolons. So this is what I'll do now here in this expression. I click on OK, and now we handle the cookie from the previous step and also add it here for this second step. Then we are ready to actually update or create the product that we are looking for. So we got the information from the extraction, and now we need to enter this product ID. So if I scroll down here to our process and save information from forms, then we can see the values that are returned from this forms recognizer. And the first property that we are interested in is this table one product ID value. So we'll take this one. Then we also need to take the name. So I'll scroll down here again and take the table one name value, We'll do the same for the price. Let me scroll up here. So we'll take the same for the price. So there's the table one price value. And then finally for the description, we can take the table one description value. So for the rest of the information, we'll actually hard code some information. So we'll use the type code here, product. We'll hard code the category as notebooks. And again, in a productive environment, you would probably also obviously look up this information. Either you have this in the PDF document, or you would maybe do an additional lookup to the SAP system to retrieve this information. But here we'll just hard code this information. Similarly with the supplier. Of course, from the incoming email, we could determine and look up the supplier number. Again, in my specific case, I'll just hard code a certain value. I'll do the same for the other. So we'll take this as US dollar, the unit of measure. We'll select each down here. And then for the weight unit, we'll actually select kilogram. So again, I just want to highlight, typically we would all make these dynamic parameters and really look up the relevant information either from the PDF document or make some additional calls to the SAP system. But in our specific case, that's good enough. So we're good to go. And with these properties, we can actually then create the product in the SAP system. So before we test this specific flow, I actually quickly want to take a look at the overall flow. And the interesting thing is, as soon as we added here this product ID or the product name, something happened to this add product functionality. And that is, it was encapsulated in this apply to each loop. So automatically, Power Automate detected that this product ID can be part of multiple products. I mean, keep in mind, the table that we have in our PDF document did contain multiple products. So that's what immediately happened. We added this product ID, and Power Automate saw that, well, this can be one of many products that is part of this table. So it automatically added this specific loop here. So what we want to do now is, just for debugging purposes or tracing purposes, whenever we create such a product, we actually want to send an email to ourselves with this information products. And then we'll just add here the same properties like the table display name, the product ID, and stuff like that. So, I mean, this is not required, but just for us, for from a tracing perspective, we want to have this in here. And I'll just move this down here so that we send the email and then we actually create the product in the SAP system. So with this, let me save this flow again, and we can test it via Outlook. So as before, we'll switch over to Outlook and we'll send an email to ourselves. So we'll send the email to Johnny. Please an add product. We'll add our attachment with the different products PDF document. And we will send over this email to ourselves. So you can see here, these are the product IDs, HBK1000 and so on. And if we click on send, then the email obviously arrives in a few seconds in our inbox. So as before, the Power Automate flow will get triggered. So if we switch over to Power Automate, if we take a look at the run history, we can just refresh the screen here. Then we can see that the Power Automate flow is actually running. And as before, we will see the Outlook is triggered. Exactly, here we go. So it's running. The PDF document has been extracted or is currently being extracted or analyzed. And then once that is done, we'll run through each of the table entries, which then obviously we will use to create in the SAP system. So you can see it took like 8 seconds to analyze this specific form. We can see everything is fine. There was one attachment, but then we can see in this attachment, there were actually 3 different items in this specific table. So we have this send email just to have an assurance that everything is working fine. that we see the values. Obviously, we can remove this email later on. But what is most interesting is if we now go to our SAP functions, the get product, then we can see here's the fetch functionality. So we provided this fetch email and or header property, and we got a CSRF token back in reply. Then we'll use this CSRF token, we'll replace the header information from the previous step, and then we add this information from our forms recognizer. So the product ID that we got dynamically, the supplier ID, which we hard coded, and we're doing this for all three products that we found. Now, if we actually then head over to the Fiori Launchpad and take a look at the products that are actually there, so if we search for HBK in this list, then we'll see the three products, Surface 1, Surface 2, Surface 3, that we created out of the PDF document and the table list that contained these three product items. So I hope now you are able to actually create the product in the SAP system with the three steps or the few steps that we have, that we react to an incoming email, that we extract the relevant information from the PDF document, and that we are using the custom connector to create the products in the SAP system. We have everything in place that we need. So in the next videos, we'll concentrate on making this scenario a little more real life by adding an approval step and by making sure that there is at least some interaction between the user and the system before the product is actually created in the SAP system.